The official name of this team is the Coastal Fisheries Restoration Team.
You got it right. It's pretty nebulous. None of us actually, I think, knew we were on a team, but it kind of makes sense because we all do aquatic habitat restoration.
And it's not just all about restoration on the ground. It's acquisition, it's preservation of habitats and lands, it's planning and strategies for the future.
Currently, because of human development and sea level rise, subsidence in the coastal area, it's having a huge impact on the natural resources.
Marsh loss in this area is huge. It, you know, it's over 35,000 acres just in the Galveston Bay complex alone. You know, our projects are a drop in the bucket. Everything's really starting to spread too, getting rhizomes shooting out, looks real healthy, and it really is just a drop in the bucket. But every drop counts.
When we're working on a project may take several years to develop and to implement.
We're finding that there is a lot of support for restoration efforts all up and down the Texas coast, and this will make it easier in the future to go after funding. And funding sources are also pushing for more restoration efforts as they see that this is vital to ecological success.
But then we also have opportunities within our community. The one I'm working with in Dickinson is a watershed partnership. And that there was a wedge where sediment had accumulated in the channel. Okay, so let's remove the sediment, use it in a beneficial use method, and create habitat. That accomplishes a water quality goal, that accomplishes a habitat and fisheries goal. The main thing is it benefits the whole community.
The habitat conservation projects I work on involve the placement of legal protection through conservation easements, which provides perpetual protection for wetlands and stream habitats.
Unfortunately, fish kill events do occur. When that happens, we identify the responsible party and then seek compensation for those resources that were impacted. Those monies that we receive are then funneled into many of these restoration projects.
Groups, you know, they've all come to the table and they've been willing to be reasonable and compromise when necessary, and who like each other now, at least if they didn't to begin with.
So this is an example of a coastal habitat restoration project where 3 years ago this area was almost all open water.
Conductivity 117.7.
I think everyone on our team is so dedicated and so passionate about their work that it shows. They'll do what it takes to get projects done, and they take pride and sense of ownership.
I do think every drop counts, so that's why I continue to do it, because these projects don't come easy. They are hard. And they're a lot of work, a lot of stress, a lot of sleepless nights. But it is for this end goal, and I think we do a good job at that, and that's why we are successful with our projects.